Very good morning to all the students of class 10th D. Still students are joining, already waited for 5 minutes. Let's discuss the points written on the board first. Clear? And then we will yes, Peter. Reflection is there, but nothing is written over there where reflection is falling. So, poem Amanda is written by Robin Kleene. The very first point is Amanda, 10 to 12 year old probably. So, why I have written probably? Because the age of the girl is not at all mentioned in the poem. So, we have to, you know, make an estimation. And I already discussed with you yesterday that we have estimated that she's between 10 to 12 because she's talking about being mermaid, she's talking about being orphaned, and she's talking about, she reads the princess's book named Rapunzel. She talks about she wanted to be like Rapunzel, that princess. So this is the age group of the girls, or at this age, they read such kind of prince and princess story. So that's why we have estimated, okay? So there is no exact answer to this. So that's why 10 to 12, probably we have to write along with that. You cannot say, yes, she is 10 years old, no. You cannot give a confirmed answer. You have to use the word probably with that, okay? So then we have, these points are based on the question answers which we are going to discuss. You will be answering it, I won't be, okay? But I'm giving you the hints prior to that. Then constantly pointed out by one of her parents. Now, why I have written one of the parents? I have not written mother. Exactly, because nowhere in the poem we get to know that whether the mother is giving instructions to Amanda or father is giving instructions to Amanda. So what is the problem of Amanda? She is getting constant pointing out, constant instructions, what to do and what not to do, especially what not to do, okay? And one of her parents in bracket may have written probably by mother, because this is assumed that, you know, mothers remain at home and mothers, they give instructions to the children all the time, what to do, how to sit, how to eat and all. So probably most of the children are raised by mother. So that's why I have written probably mother. So we have to assume that mother is there only. Okay. So then next is Amanda thinks herself to be. What she thinks of herself, then first stanza, she thinks herself to be a mermaid. She wants to feel relaxed. She wants to feel the freedom in the deep sea where no other creature is there. She wants to be the only, you can say, resident of that place. She has mentioned that only inhabitant. Inhabitant means resident. Then she wants to be an orphan. Orphan is the child whose both the parents are no more. So she wants to be an orphan because she thought that if my parents keep on, nagging me all the time and giving me instructions for not doing the good behavior, so I should be an orphan. I could wander the streets all alone without any consent. And then she imagines herself to be one of the fictional character Rapunzel. So story of Rapunzel also, I will ask one of you. So be ready with that, okay? I will not tell you the story, already discussed with you. Then she wants to have freedom. At the end, I have written that Amanda wants to have freedom. Clear? She's feeling suffocated and she wants to have freedom. Okay, is it clear to all of you? Now, let me show you the questions. Okay, these are the 9 questions, NCERT questions at the back of the book when poem ends, thinking about the poem. So now, okay, Dakshita.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Dakshita, you tell us, you can say within 3-4 lines, what is there in this poem. You tell the idea, the summary, you can say.
Ma'am, this poem Amanda is written by Robin Kleene, in which the views of little girl named Amanda are depicted. Her parents constantly point out her for her mistakes. And she is fed up of that and she wants freedom.
Yes, so this is what we have already discussed. So well done, Dakshita, for this. Anybody else? Those who want to? Equal chances are given. Those who do not participate earlier, they can also speak. Fine. Archie.
Good morning.
Good Good morning, Archie. So what do you think is the idea behind this poem? What is the theme of this poem? We already discussed yesterday.
The poem is all about how few of the parents want their child to fit in the frame made by the society for a good child. It is all about how parents constantly point out their child's mistake and how children are facing mental pressures in today's life. And all about the parents-child relationship nowadays.
Yes, so this poem is all about parents-child relationship and how parents are being, you can say, giving in too many instructions to the children. They are being too much possessed. They are expecting a lot from their kids. And then responsible parenting. That is also one of the very important themes. Responsible parenting should be there. Okay. Still students are joining, see, in between. This is a thing happening daily basis. So responsible parenting is there. Mental pressure faced by the children is also one of the themes. Okay, and what should be a good relation between child and mother or father? That is also one of the themes. And freedom and one's own choices should be kept at the foremost place. So freedom is mandatory for all the kids. So that is also one of the themes. So thank you, Archie, for telling us that. Now, very first question, how old do you think Amanda is? How do you know this? I already answered this question while explaining the points. So anybody who would like to answer this, how old do you think Amanda is and how do you know this? Who will answer this question? Nobody will raise hand. I have to. Okay, Bisham.
I think Amanda is 10 to 12 years old because at this age a child read about the fictional stories. And this is clear from the chapter.
So yes, you can mute yourself. Amanda's age could be between. You will not write. Okay, Parina, you will answer this. Answer the second question. You are raising hand for this. So you can answer the next question. Let me discuss the answer of first one. Fine. So Amanda's age could be between. Would be between. But I don't write that she is. 10-year-old, she is 11. You cannot, you know, give that. Chahat is saying 9 to 10. So that is, you can say the age group, you can write. So Amanda's age is probably between 9 to 12 or 10 to 12-year-old. We can guess this because of the reference to mermaid, because of the reference to the story of Rapunzel. So these stories, stories of mermaids and stories of you can say Rapunzel, these fictional characters are basically read by the children of age group between 10 to 12 only. So we are not considering teenage into this, okay? Before teenage, pre-teenage age, ko hum le rahe hain beech mein se 10 to 12. And moreover, she is being pointed out by small, or you can say little things like biting of the nails, hunching the shoulders, slouching position, laziness. And these are the traits which are associated with this age group basically. Fine. These are, you can say these can be, you know, these are applicable to us also otherwise. But in this context, we have to mention that. Okay. So second question. Parina, would you like to answer? Raise your hand, Parina. Where are you? Because a lot of students are there. Okay, fine. Yes, Parina, you answer the second question. Read the question first and then answer.
What do you think is speaking to her?
Who do you think is speaking to her?
I think Amanda is talking to one of her parents, probably her mother, because she is scolding not to behave in a very ill manner. And she tries to tell her daughter to well behave in her home.
Okay, thank you, Beta. You can mute yourself. So actually, firstly, this is also, I've already discussed on the board. So one of her parents is probably speaking to, not probably here, one of the parents is definitely speaking to her, but we think that probably it is the mother, because this is the general perception in our society that children are raised by mothers at home, basically. Fine. So that's why we are considering that she is talking to her mother. We have to give the answer. Fact de rahe hain aapko, clear? Third question. Why are stanzas 2, 4 and 6 given in parentheses? Who will answer this? Raise your hand, beta. Jaldi jaldi se. Don't waste time. Divyansh is there. Hasita, Jia Dhawan, Laksh Kakkar, Mehak. Divyansh wants to answer this. Okay, Divyansh, you answer this. Okay, Chahat, I'm going to do that. Yes.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, Divyansh. Please give the answer to this question.
Ma'am, in these stanzas 2, 4, and 6,
yes. Are you going to give the answer or shall I continue? Reflect the inner thoughts of Amanda. Yes, Laksh Kakkar, bilkul sahi. Exactly. Let me share the questions. Those who are saying they want to see the question. Beta, please keep your books. I will be sharing the screen, no doubt, but you should have the books with you so that you can note down. So Laksh has given very apt answer in the chat box that these are actually, you can say, the feelings of this girl. So in stanza 2, 4, and 6, what is parenthesis? Parenthesis is a remark, you know, bracket. We call in a formal language, we call it parenthesis. So in mathematics, so parenthesis is a remark that is added to a sentence actually. Fine. So parenthesis is a remark added to a sentence, often to provide an explanation of that sentence. So that's why we put parentheses, we use parentheses. Firstly, you will tell that. So in stanza 2nd, 4th and 6th, parenthesis is used to describe the reaction of Amanda or feelings and thought process of Amanda towards her mother's continuous nagging behavior. N-A-G-G-I-N-G, okay? That is, nagging behavior is when you are pointing out others at silly things only, small things also, fine? So that's why thoughts of Amanda, her reaction to the sentence and her feelings, you can say, are described, her reaction is described to the statements given by the mother. So that's why these are put up in the parentheses. Is it clear to all of you? Now, fourth question is, who is the speaker in stanza 2, 4 and 6? Do you think the speaker is listening to the speaker in stanza 1, 3, 5 and 7? Anybody? Very easy question. This is very easy. You need not see the number. See, in the very first stanza, instructions are being given. Third, maybe instructions and pointing out. Fifth, maybe. Who's pointing out? We all know mother. Fine. One of the parents, probably mother, is pointing out. And in second, fourth and sixth, reactions are given by Amanda. So it is very, very clear to all of us that speaker in stanza 2, 4 and 6 is Amanda. Fine. Remember, because this point started with the conversation of the mother. So odd numbers are belonging here to mother. So mother is a speaker of all the odd paragraphs 1, 3, 5 and 7. And Amanda is speaker of all the even paragraphs, that is 2nd, 4th and 6th. You will not write odd even in the answer. I'm just telling you, discussing with you, okay? So you'll mention that speaker in stanza 2, 4 and 6 is Amanda, whereas speaker in stanza 1, 3, 5 and 7 is mother. Now they are asking, second part of the question is, you will change the paragraph to answer the second part of the question. Do you think the speaker is listening to the speaker in stanza 1, 3, 5 and 7? You can say that she, you know, no, she is not paying attention. Fine. No, she is not paying attention to what her mother says because she is lost in her own imagination. She is lost in her own imaginary world. She is thinking, she is having her own thought process. Fine. So she imagines herself to be a mermaid. Then she imagines herself to be an orphan. Then she imagines herself to be Rapunzel, that fictional character. So that's why we don't think so, that she is paying attention to mother's words clearly. Okay. Next question is, what could Amanda do if she were a mermaid? This is a question. It will be, you know, vary with having varied answers. If she would, okay, Princey wants to answer this. Yes, beta.
If she were a mermaid, Amanda wishes to be in a, or blissfully drift in a tranquil sea and enjoy the solitary.
Yes, so according to Princy, if Amanda would be the mermaid, what she wanted to do, not according to her particular, okay, same, every like to add up something else? Yes, same. You are just raising hand.
Amanda wishes to be a mermaid so she could carelessly move along a languid emerald sea. She just wishes to be carried away the green sea waves slowly and gradually. Amanda longs for a place where she is all by herself, as her happiness is not dependent on any other human being. So she desires to be a mermaid because for a child, mermaid is a symbol of freedom and wonder.
Very good. So this is the exact answer. I need not even add anything into it. Here I wanted to add up when Princy spoke. Yes, Princy, well done to you also. And the same beautiful answer given by you. So clear? I don't think so. I need to add up anything. Actually, children, they do not like to be pointed out again and again. They love to live life full of freedom. And she imagines herself to be, you can say, a mermaid. And she wanted to, be all by herself. And she wanted to be the only creature in the whole sea without any disturbance, without any interruption. She wanted to be carried away by the waters of the sea. Emerald means green colored sea. And she wanted to relish that freedom. Okay. So this is what she would do if she were a mermaid. She has already mentioned. Clear? Is Amanda an orphan? Why does she say so? Jinki turn aa chuki hai, please do not raise hand. Those who have already given the answers, I won't be giving chances again to them. Yes, now we have Mehak. Yes, Mehak, you can speak, beta.
No, Amanda is not an orphan, but she wants to be she wants to have a life like an orphan because she is very tired of her optic constant nagging by her mother, and she wants to live all alone and wants to enjoy everything. She wants to play in sand with her bare feet, and she wants to enjoy her life without worrying about that her mother will scold her.
Okay, you can mute yourself, Meg. Fine. So, no, Amanda is not an orphan. An orphan is a child whose parents are dead. So, it's obvious that she's being pointed out by parents. So, we will mention that no, Amanda is not an orphan. But she wanted to be an orphan. She felt like being an orphan because she was so depressed because of constant pointing by her mother. And she was feeling so suffocated by getting too many instructions for little things. She was getting instructions for biting her nails, for sitting properly, for not having good posture of sitting, and so on. So she was feeling that if she will be an orphan, nobody will be interrupting her. She would be able to move freely outside, wander in the streets, and no, you can say, restrictions will be imposed upon her. So that's why she wanted to, and in her dejection and depression, she said so. Clear? They are asking, why does she say so? She wanted to, you can say she said so because she was not able to have peaceful life and free life. Okay. So next question, anybody, please raise your hand. Those who have not answered earlier. Do you know the story of Rapunzel? Why does she want to be Rapunzel? Very easy question. Yes, Vanita. Yes, beta.
Ma'am, she wants to be Rapunzel because she wants to live alone. Rapunzel lived in a tall tower and had a long, beautiful hairs. That's why she wants to be away from and she wants to be alone from all and want to live in that tower and don't allow anyone to come to climb in that tower with her hairs. The girl also want to live alone in the tower, and she don't wants to care about anyone.
She doesn't.
And
doesn't want.
Would have peaceful and a rare life in that tower.
Okay, Vita, very good, Vanita. You tried and gave answer in a beautiful way. Well done, and keep participating. Now I really appreciate students who are participating wholeheartedly. More girls and less number of boys. So you should participate all, okay? So, what now? Do you know the story of Rapunzel? Why does she want to be Rapunzel? Firstly, beta, you have to answer the first part. You have to mention the story of Rapunzel, okay, in detail. The story of Rapunzel is of a girl who is captured by an old witch in a tower. Fine. The old witch climbs up the tower with the help of long hair of Rapunzel. Fine. And she lets down her through a window of the tower. One day, a prince visits her by climbing the tower with the help of long hair. Fine. And when the witch comes to know that a prince is also able to enter the tower, she, you know, separates both of them. She got to know that witch got to know that a prince is also there who is climbing the tower with the help of her hair. And she, you know, separates them. And but both Rapunzel and prince, they meet after a gap of many years. When that witch separated them, I'm just telling you the story, fine, in short. So after many years, they met, and it was only possible with the help of Rapunzel's long hair that they would, you know, people were able to, or anybody was able to reach there. So that is the story. And then they started living together after many years when they meet each other. So that was the story of Rapunzel. Now, second part is, why does she want to be Rapunzel? Now, why she imagined herself to be Rapunzel? Because she... you know, Amanda feels that life in the tower will be the best life suited to her, because she wanted her own freedom. She did not want to be disturbed by anyone. She was fed up with the, you know, outer society. She wanted to be all alone at secluded place. She wanted solitude, fine. Usko peace chahiye tha, and she wanted that there will be no one to give her instructions, no one. She wanted to lead a rare life. So that's why she imagines herself to be Rapunzel. And she would, and she also mentioned that when she will be living in the tower, she will not let her long hair down. She will not allow anyone to enter in the tower. So she was so frustrated. You can very well imagine. Fine. She never wanted to get disturbed by any of the visitors. Now, what does the girl yearn for? Yearning means demand. Okay. What does the girl yearn for? What does this poem tell you about Amanda? Actually, better see. These seem to be 9 questions, but actually there are more than that, like 12, 13 questions, because most of the questions are having 2 parts. So when 2-part question is there, you have to answer both the parts. Now, what does the girl yearn for? What does this poem tell you about Amanda? So I'm going to answer last 2 questions because only a few minutes are left, so that we are able to complete this poem today only. Clear? And please do all these 9 questions in your fair notebook also. Don't think that we are in online mode, we won't be writing. Yes, you have to write questions as well as answers to the questions in the fair notebook. Okay. What does the girl yearn for? What does this poem tell you about Amanda? So the girl Amanda yearns for freedom and peace in her life. Fine. She is constantly reminded of her mistakes. Her parents want her to follow the code of conduct as per societal norms. They wanted her to behave in a nice way, fine. And they are doing so because they wanted to make the child in a well-behaved manner. But while doing so, they forgot that she is also a human being. They forgot that she also has the right to live freely, fine. She wants some her own space and freedom. So the poet has drawn the reader's attention towards the condition of children who are constantly pointed out for small things, fine, and they are being oppressed by their parents in the name of good behavior. Clear? So this is what poem is telling us about Amanda, okay? The girl yearns for freedom and peace. She does not want any interference. She does not want to be pointed out again and again. This is what she wishes. And then what does the poem tell you about Amanda? That is separate paragraph you will make, okay? Now, the last question, read the last stanza. Do you think Amanda is sulking and is moody? Fine. Sulking is, I already told you, when you are nagging about, when you are, you know, having behavior which is not required and you're not sitting in a right posture. You does not, you know, you're not participating happily in anything and, you know, cribbing for no reason. That means the sulking. So, and being moody, switching fluctuations of moods. One moment you are irritated, the other moment you are happy, in the third moment you are showing some more tantrums. So, according to mother, Amanda is sulking and moody. So, they are asking you now. You will not, you know, borrow mother's thoughts. What do you think Amanda is sulking and moody? in our sense, Amanda is not moody. Fine. Amanda is not moody and she's not sulking. Actually, she is frustrated. Fine. She is feeling oppressed because of constant nagging behavior shown by her mother. Okay. She's feeling suppressed, oppressed, and dejected out of it. Fine. She's feeling suffocated in that relation. So she was pointed out by mother to clean the room and clean her shoes. And she's the girl who sometimes like to live by creating a mess in her room. And the girl who does not want to wear the shoes. And she wants to remain bare feet by making patterns in the sand, in the mud. She wants to feel that. And mother wants to behave in a nice way. Wants her to behave in a nice way. Fine. And then she was being pointed out for biting her nails, for not sitting straight, for constant pressure to trying a well-behaved girl was there. So according to us, because of constant nagging and constant pointing out, she became dejected. She is not at all moody. Okay, with this, our poem Amanda ends here along with question answers. Any doubt is there, you can ask me. Time ho chuka hai. I'm about to end the meet. Before that, I would like to ask if any doubt is there to any of you. Send me thumbs up, those who are still attending. I can see Dakshita is there. Yes. Parina, Mehak, Bissam, Seyam, Parikshit, Divyansh, Archie, Aryan, Pratham, Hasita, Jia. Okay, same. Most of you are there. Okay, I just wanted to confirm that you listen. Harsimran is also there. Fine. Okay, beta. Fine. Have a nice day. And please note down the question answers and please revise also side by side. Keep on preparing your topics well. All the best.